all, this is Yanni Vijaya with you, and today we'll be moving on to the chapter The Sound of Music Part 1, Bismillah Khan. This is a chapter taken from Beehive textbook of grade 9. So before, without wasting our time, we will directly move to chapter Bismillah Khan. As you can see the subtitle itself, you might have understood that this is basically a biography about Bismillah Khan. Okay, so we will move on. So Bismillah Khan is a name which might be familiar to each one of you. But yes, we are looking into his life, but also along with Bismillah Khan's life, we should look into one more thing. What is that? Shehnai. Shehnai is one instrument which everyone might be familiar. Now, how did it originate and how did Bismillah Khan be famous? How did he become famous? All these things we will look into through this chapter. So when the story begins, it is said that Aurangzeb, the Emperor Aurangzeb, this is something happening years and years back, okay? Emperor Aurangzeb banned Pungi. Do you know what's Pungi? If you don't know, I'll just post the image of Pungi right here. Pungi is basically a musical instrument basically played in royal residence. So what happened was, this Pungi had a very bad noise. Because of this bad noise, what happened? Aurangzeb, the emperor, told it has got a very bad noise, and the whole that particular instrument was completely banned. He said that this was basically an unpleasant noise. The Pungi was producing an unpleasant noise. So what happened? There was a person, there was a barber. You know who's a barber, right? Barber, and also he was a musician. So what he did, he thought of reviving the instrument called Pungi. So what did he do? Pungi, as you might have seen, it's basically like an instrument which is normally seen in a snake charmer's hand. Okay, so this Pungi was taken aside, and then this particular barber took this instrument and tried to ensure the pipe, just like he took a stick and then he ensured the pipe was long enough, not like Pungi, and he started to make holes on it, and then he revived the instrument and it produced a beautiful sound. And that was one reason that most of the kings and emperors loved this particular instrument. So now they had a confusion. What name they would give for this instrument? So what did they do? This particular instrument called, name is not given, it was played in Mr. Shah's royal court. Shah. So they took Shah, that particular term, and then who revived it? A barber. So barber was known as Nai. Okay, so they took the, where was it played? Shah's chamber. Who did that? Nai. Nai means barber. So they brought it together and they gave the name as Shehnai. That is how this instrument called Shehnai came popular. Now, if you ask anybody how did Shehnai became popular, the basic reason of who made it popular, the answer would be Bismillah Khan. Bismillah Khan was a person who made this instrument called Shehnai very, very popular. It is not just Bismillah Khan, but even his father and grandparents also were musicians, and they all played Shehnai. But the difference between Bismillah Khan was, Bismillah Khan played the instrument initially in temples and in the country India. Later on, he even moved to other countries and he played the instrument Shehnai. That is how he became very, very popular, and that is how the instrument called Shehnai became very popular. So in the very first part of the story, The Sound of Music Part 1, we are coming to know more about the instrument Shehnai, how it was originated. So Shehnai is basically an instrument played for Naubat. You know what's Naubat? Naubat is basically completeness of 9 instruments. So Shehnai was also included as a 9th instrument. So where are these 9 instruments together played? Basically in temples and wedding. So as you all know that Shehnai, this music produces a very soothing and peace, and it's just like a good omen. That is the reason why they also added this particular instrument for wedding and other traditional festivals and temples. After this, this is where the introduction stops. In the second part of the story, we come to know about whom? Bismillah Khan. So who was Bismillah Khan? The beginning of it has been said, Bismillah Khan, who was 5 years old, he used to play Gilli Danda. You know what's Gilli Danda? I'm sure over there most of you, especially Indians, might know what is Gilli Danda. If you don't know, I'll surely post a picture over here. He used to play, that was the beginning what we are coming to know about Bismillah Khan. And the thing what we can know about the thing is, he used to go to a temple and sing. Now why is he going to temple and sing? Just this one thing what I would like to say. What is his name? Bismillah Khan. Where is he going to sing? A temple. Social tolerance. Religious tolerance. This is something which we should look into. This is a story which is happening in 1930s. Okay, just before, few years before the independence, 1925, 1930s, like that. So at that point of time, the religious tolerance was at zenith. People loved each other. May you be a Muslim, a Christian, a Hindu, whatever it is, there was uniformity, oneness was there. Okay, even now we know our country, India, is known for one. United we stand. Right? So that's one thing what we have to remember. This Bismillah Khan used to go to temple to sing. And why did he do that? He did that because at the end of that, he would get 1.25 kg weight laddu. To get the big laddu, he used to go to temple and sing. Now, what happened? So initially, it's the right from his childhood, he had this passion for musical instruments, singing, etc. So basically, as I told you, his father and his grandfather all had this taste towards the singing. Rasul Bakhsh was his grandfather and Paigambar Bakhsh was his father. So two of them were also Shehnai players. Okay, they were great Shehnai players. And as you can look into the lineage of his father's side, okay, we say paternal side, everybody were musicians, but it's not just his father's side, even mother's side. Okay, at the age of 3, the mother took him to his uncle. What is his uncle's name? His uncle's name is again Ali Bakhsh. Okay. So this was basically maternal side and this was basically paternal side. So his uncle was there, Ali Bakhsh. Ali Bakhsh also played Shehnai, the instrument. And then he took him to different places where he would go to singing and playing the national instruments, etc. And for some years, Ustad Bismillah Khan, basically Bismillah Khan's mother is from Varanasi, Benares. And Bismillah Khan stayed there in Varanasi for some time. So always this child used to be with Ali Bakhsh's uncle, okay, maternal uncle. And Ali Bakhsh used to take him to different places basically because he knew that he had this taste for singing and playing instruments. And as you all know that Banaras is one place where you know it is in the bank of River Ganga. That is also one positive point which you have to look into. Okay, and we also know that he was deeply motivated and inspired by the Ganga River. Most of the time he used to spend in the banks of River Ganga. Okay, and the thing is, at the age of 14, he accompanied his uncle to Allahabad, and over there he met a person called Ustad Faiz Khan. And Ustad Faiz Khan, he recited a poetry and he appreciated. There's something which we have to note. We are with a person for a long time, but if the person appreciates, it's basically a very good thing, right? So he was with Ali Bakhsh for quite a long time, and then once he recited in front of Ustad Faiz Khan and he appreciated. That's one thing which actually changes, like he still remembers that particular appreciation which he got at the age of 14. Now, and the thing is, he then joined to All India Radio. That's another turning point in All India Radio. During the independence time, it was Bismillah Khan who basically greeted the people with his Shehnai music. So he was there in All India Radio where he played his Shehnai music on air, and after that 15th August 1947 he was the first person to greet the people with his Shehnai music. And after that Jawaharlal Nehru's first speech after independence is very very famous and everybody know about it. That is also mentioned in the textbook. And after that in the textbook it's also mentioned that he traveled to many places. Initially he mentions about Afghanistan. He goes there and perform, and King Zahir Shah has gifted him a lot of Persian carpet, which is very very costly. And another thing what is also being mentioned over there in the textbook is about how he was ready to perform in different countries so that they would know the rich culture and tradition of India. And even now you may have seen many Westerners are coming to our country to learn our culture and our tradition. So we should also analyze and think, are we respecting our culture and tradition? What are we into? We are too much into looking into others' tradition, others' culture, etc. But then we ourselves are forgetting what is our culture and our tradition. What you might be familiar, you might be knowing is, he was also there as a music director in two films, okay? You might be familiar with the thing Goonj Uthi Shehnai. Film field is basically a lot of artificiality and glamour. So he basically didn't like the film world. He was also in Australia, Ontario, Montreal, Osaka Trade Fair, all these places he got an opportunity to perform in front of many people. And he has also won a lot of national awards like Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan. And as you know, he is also a person who has won Bharat Ratna, which is the highest civilian award. So all these things is something which we have to know about it. And he says, there's one thing which he says in the textbook, teach your children music. This is Hindustan's richest tradition. Even the West is coming to learn our music. So it is our duty that we should know our culture and our heritage instead of just going to other places. That's one thing what Bismillah Khan speaks over here in this chapter. And there's also one more place where one of his students in USA asked him to, why don't you come over there and I'll just reproduce whatever you have there in Bismillah Khan, whatever you have there in Varanasi. At that time, Ustad Bismillah Khan asked a question to him, can you reproduce the river Ganga over there? Because he says, wherever I am, I have this I have to river, I have to go back to my place, river Ganga. And that's one thing which he says, wherever he is, he always is longing to go back to Varanasi. That's a perfect example for rich culture and tradition, because he is a person who wherever he is, he loves to be back in his place, India. That's one thing we have to note and we have to salute him, because it's because of him we came to know a lot about the Shehnai instrument, because the Shehnai instrument became so popular through Bismillah Khan. That's one thing which we have to admit. At the age of 90 in 2006 he died, and he was given all honors from the government. Okay, that's one thing which to be noted. At the age of 90, till the age of 90 he was serving for the country and for the musicians, for the people. And another thing what we look into is, he had some illness, that's how he passed away. This is about Bismillah Khan. As you can see, a person who sang just for 1.5 kg laddu has got the highest civilian award. Uncle has played a major role, Ali Bakhsh, to train him. And then Rasul Bakhsh's grandfather and Paigambar Bakhsh's father. This is paternal side, this is maternal side. So how this Pungi instrument revived and came to Shehnai, and how it was popular. That is what something which we came to know about Bismillah Khan, because everybody are so popular knowing about the musicians and the instrument players of other country. How far we know about our own country, the players? That's something which is basically the writer is asking to us through this story, through this biography. I hope you have understood the story. The important question which might be asked is, why was the Pungi instrument completely banned? As I told you, it was giving a very harsh noise, okay? Because of the, that coarse voice, hard voice, it was completely banned. Okay, was the Shehnai instrument played traditionally, and what was the change brought in? All those things can be asked. One thing is, why did Bismillah Khan refuse to the student that he was not ready to come to USA? The reason I already told you, because he asked the student whether he could bring the river Ganga to USA. So those are the important questions. I hope the video was really useful for you. If you're watching this video for the very first time, please don't forget to subscribe the video, like and share it with all your friends. Okay? So stay safe. God bless you. You take care. Nivi Raju signing off. Bye.